et du média. I will speak about electricity today. Do you know the difference between electric charge, electric field, electric force, and electric potential? Actually, here is a charge. Electric charge, a dot charge, is plus or minus. I can change the sign by clicking on it. And this charge, you cannot see this, but there is a perturbation, which we call electric perturbation, all around the world, all around this charge. And the best way for us to illustrate this perturbation is, for example, to add another charge. For example, here, I will make a charge, a minus charge, and I will say that if this charge is free of movement, then a force will act on it. And then I can see that this minus charge is attracted by the plus charge. I can change this with a plus charge and understand that there is a kind of repulsion now. What you have to understand also is that this charge experiences a force which is higher in magnitude when it is close to the charge and lower in magnitude, and the force decreases when you are far away. If I launch this charge, I can see a kind of elliptic motion which is very close to the gravitational motion. But what we like to do is to consider that even if I don't have any charge around this, there is the perturbation. And then I need a vector to illustrate what we call a field, electric field. There is a field here, 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 everywhere. And I can say that the field is higher here than here. I will use the field lines here to draw a kind of symmetry to understand this, the symmetry of the perturbation. And then, I think I will stop it now, and we will see in another video how the equipotentials and electric potentials can also describe these electric fields.